invite you through the Holy Spirit to be with us through this service, so that we are indeed inspired, lifted, and will leave here with an enriched spirit to go and serve you in a way better than we have in the past. For this is our prayer in unison in Jesus' name. And all of God's people said, amen.
Surgery last Tuesday, and the surgery And it's going to be shown at 11 a.m. and 6 p.m. twice a day for free at the Sears Town Hall. And it starts July 17 and runs through July 24. So that's a real nice opportunity for everybody here.
What's a paper? And with that, that's all the announcements we have for today. So can we go ahead with our hymn, Standing on the Promises of Christ My King? Thank you.
7:08. That's okay. We've got a good group here this morning. We've got 8 people, and I haven't had 8 things in my hand. So this is going to work out really, really well. Miss Amy, I might need your help this morning. Okay? I'm going to hand each of you something. What is it? Tell everybody what it is.
Shoelaces.
It's not going to work too good with my shoes, is it? Well, open up your, take the paper off of your shoelaces. Or just pull them out if you want to. You can leave the paper there. There you go. 2 shoelaces. Tie the shoelaces, one around your left leg and one around your right leg. The same way you might have to help a little bit. Nope, don't worry about it. You're not going to put them back in the paper. You're going to keep them. They're yours. It's okay. You're going to take them with you. You can put them in your pocket. Tie them around your leg. Just tie them around so they're tied around your leg somehow. Something else with them. Just leave the ends hanging off. It's okay. It's fine. Okay. Miss Amy tied their feet together. Let's try this again. Okay, I just want you to tie them around your legs, but it's okay if there's a lot hanging off because we're going to do something else, okay? It's okay. All right. Now, I want you to figure out who your neighbor is. Okay? You have a neighbor? Do you have someone sitting next to you?
Are you my neighbor?
Can we be neighbors? You're my neighbor? You're neighbors? Okay. Here's what we're going to do, and I'm going to show you with my neighbor. So my neighbor is now tied to me. Okay, so tie yourself to your neighbor. And don't double knot it. I didn't bring the scissors. It's okay. We're tied together. That's all that matters. We're tied together. Okay? So you're tied to somebody on one side. Are you tied to somebody on the other side? Could you be? Okay. If you can, tie yourself to your other neighbor. Do not double knot these things. Okay, good. Oh, I'm getting tied in here too. Very good. Okay. So we have a neighbor on each side of us, okay? But what about the people out here? There are neighbors. What about the people back here? There are neighbors. We can't tie them in with our shoelaces, can we? What about the people in India? Are they our neighbors? Yeah? What about China, Russia, Africa, Australia? Everywhere is our neighbor. How many of you have heard the story of the Good Samaritan in the Bible? You know the Good Samaritan? Can you tell a real short version of it, like super short?
One man was traveling along the road, and 2 thieves came and stole his money and beat him up really bad. So one person came by and said, "I don't have time for this," and left. The next person came by and said, "I don't have time for this," and left. But the third person, which was the Good Samaritan, came and helped the man, and the 2 thieves were arrested, and and the man is happily ever after.
Good job, Dan. So, and Jesus told this story to his disciples, and he ended it with a question. He said, which of the three men was the neighbor? The two that beat him up or the one that took care of him? The one that took care of him, the Samaritan. And I don't know if you remember, but in the story, the Samaritan and him didn't even like each other. They were like enemies. They were people that were like, we don't even get along. Yeah, the Samaritan was not a friendly person. So we're all friendly, and we're all tied together, and we don't mind being tied together. But being a neighbor doesn't just mean taking care of the people right beside us. Jesus told his disciples one time, I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no water. I was homeless, and you gave me no shelter. And they immediately looked at Jesus and said, when did we do that? We didn't do that. He said, if you've done that to anyone, you've done it to me. So Jesus was really strong about the fact that we are all neighbors. You may not know me. You may not even like me. But we're still neighbors, and if you were hurt, I would try to take good care of you, and I hope you would take good care of me. Now, having said all of that, we're going to have prayer, but I want you to try untying yourselves first. It's just tied to you. It's okay if you can leave it on. It's just untied. It's tied to someone else. There you go. Good job. Okay. I thought this through, and I was like, I know this is going to be a little bit of a, but I just had to try it. Okay. Are we untied? Sorry, Jerry. Let's have prayer together. Can everybody fold their hands? Close your eyes. You can talk with me if you want to. Dear God, we love you so much. You're the most wonderful thing ever. And you sent your Son to teach us how you want us to be. Lord, help us to hear your message, to help others when we can, and to always share your love. And now we pray together as Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day.
morning's scripture lesson. We have three scriptures from the book of James. These are all in the King James Version, from chapter 4, verses 6 through 7. But he giveth more grace, wherefore he said, God resisteth the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. Submit yourself therefore to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. From Peter, 1 Peter, chapter 5, verse 6. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. And from Jeremiah, chapter 1, verse 5. Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee. And I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Will the ushers please come forward to receive God's tithes and our offering?
13. Kidney failure from lack of blood pressure. And probably some of the contrast used in clearing the clock. And they informed this individual's wife that we got to do two things, or you're not going to live another 5 hours. One of those things was we have to start him on dialysis. And the second thing is, because in that struggle, the heart had gone into fibrillation. It spun a second blood clot and went down in the right leg. Totally blocking the circulation to the foot. And gangrene set in. So that was the reason they had to take below the knee of the right leg off. So on the morning of the 23rd day, when the wife said to the person, good morning, day number 23. They could no longer lift their left toe, and they didn't have a leg or foot mid-calf on the right leg. Now, it's interesting, having had a series from our pastor on the power of prayer and how to do that, that at the moment the doctor came in after having stayed in that hospital 72 hours so that he would be immediately close by should anything else develop that he could do. Canceled several surgeries, slept on the cot. And was there as the God servant to this one patient. So, this person worked for a state organization impacting 67 school districts. So the word went out to all 67 counties, the superintendent of those 67 counties. One of our own is in a crisis. The picture doesn't look good, and they're likely not going to live through the night. Well, it seems that there was a fundamental Baptist preacher in Baker County that happened to have a church service that evening. So he stood before the congregation and said, one of our own educators in this state is in dire need of your prayer. And this is some history about that person. This is what they do for us. And we need to pray for them. And a member of that congregation said, look, if he's that important, and he is a Christian man, as you say he is, and all indication being that he is, why don't we just get out on our face right now? Remember, this is a fundamental Baptist church. Might not be traditional, but it was appropriate. But that was said a few days ago by our membership, all chuckle. traditional but appropriate. Now, after the crisis ended, the person began to make the turn for the better. And the doctor announced to the family, "I believe he's going to make it." The family had traced that back to the exact time of that stick his eye bar out to you. And in that empty space, I ask you to just come right in. Bring a broom. Sweep out enough room in there for the Holy Spirit to live with us day in and day out. So that when temptation is on the horizon, we can just instantly know to tell you to Satan, get behind me and leave me alone. I'm not tempted by you, and I am not going to be. And I present you with cross, the blood of Jesus that was shed on that cross, and I know that you just can't stand it. Be gone from here. Be gone from me. And leave this nation alone. And we as a congregation, individually, maybe numerous times a day, are going to repeat that over and over and over until you understand, devil, you don't belong here. It's our God and our Christ that lives here. Let us now go in peace and joy, filled with hope in this party. This occasion will have been well made.